Angular 19 introduced a new kind of signal called linkedSignal. For example, we have a store page for phones. Open the component of this page. The list of model names is stored in an array. The name of the selected model is stored in a separate property. Two properties must be linked. What happens when this model's array changes? The name of the selected model remains unchanged. The linked signal allows us to automatically change the selected model value every time the model's array changes. How does this work? To use linked signal, the model's array must be signal. As a result, models is a signal, selected model is a linked signal. The signal allows tracking changes to its value. The linked signal allows reacting to signal changes using a function. The linked signal function takes a function to react as an argument. This function must return a new value for this linked signal. The signals are not linked at the moment. How to link? First, the signal value must be written in this function. We select the first model in the array as the default selected model. New to signals in Angular, check out my 20-minute tutorial. Second, the signal read must happen at least once during the first execution. This signal is not read during the first execution due to this false condition. This line of code is never executed, but we only care about the first execution. As a result, the signal is not tracked, and this function doesn't react when its value changes. The signals are now linked and work in tandem. Don't forget to import. Let's see how it works in the browser, but maybe you have a question. What is the difference between computed and linked signals? It looks similar. The computed signal is read-only, so we cannot change its value. In contrast, the linked signal is not read-only, and we can change its value. This is the main and most important difference, but not the only one. I will explain one more difference later in this video. Open the component template. Let's display the list of models and the selected model in the browser. We iterate over the array of model names to display models containing two elements. An image and a name. The selected model has a large image and a name. When the list of models changes, the reaction function is automatically triggered and updates the selected model. Let's add the code to change the selected model on click. Please Please note, we have changed the selected model. Unlike a computed signal, we can change the automatic value of a linked signal. When the list of models changes, the reaction function automatically sets the selected model based on the specified logic. This also prevents outdated values in the selected model. Now, let's add storage options to this page for each model. Next, I explain how to create automatic chains of different kinds of signals using linkedSignal. For example, we get not only model names from the API, but also a list of storages and prices for each model. First, we need to create an interface to describe the API data format. This data has a parent object and nested objects. This interface describes the requirements for key and value types. Second, we add a type annotation for the model's property. Now, this property must contain a signal holding a specific data format. Next, we need to update the component and template code. The model signal now contains an object instead of an array as before. So, the current logic of the selected model signal no longer works. The same problem exists in this loop in the template. We need to create a computed signal to fix this. This function returns an array of names from the model's signal. This computed signal automatically executes this function every time the model signal updates. The returned array is assigned to the model list property. As a result, the model list signal always holds the current list of names as a simple array of strings. Now we need to replace models with model list. The final chain of signals must consist of 5 signals. We use computed signals for lists and linked signals for selected elements. Let's write code for 2 more signals. We need to create a property for a storage list of the selected model. This list will be displayed in the selected model block. This computed signal contains a list of storage names with prices. It's the computed signal linked to the linked signal. The last signal contains the selected storage name. Now let's add a storage list to the template. Next, add a CSS class to highlight the selected elements in the lists. Time to see how it works in a real demo. When a signal updates, the signal chain updates automatically. Why did we choose computed signals for the lists? Because we only want the lists to change automatically. A linked signal has one more difference from a computed signal. We can access the previous state. This allows you to perform logic depending on the previous state.